So we're here with Huw Feeney from Dusk Group. Great to see you, mate.
Good to be here.
So you guys have just launched Aurora and Depper and St. Lucia.
Yes, correct.
How's it all going?
Not too bad. We're under construction at the moment. We specifically wanted to be under construction before we took it to the market. There's been some false starts with a lot of developers and builders over the last little while, so we wanted to give the buyers confidence that it was going to be completed. So we're powering through.
Yeah, awesome. You know, one of the things we often see on urban is that, well, as soon as construction starts, particularly in Queensland, a lot of buyers get attracted to those projects, and our visitor to someone making an inquiry really lifts. So I'm not surprised to hear you guys have had that focus.
We only just launched it, I think, about a week and a half, and there's already been significant inquiry, and there's some actual very serious inquiry for two of the bigger townhouses on the site, so we're looking forward to that.
Yeah, awesome. And so tell us more about Dusk Group. Obviously, you know, you guys have been in the sector for a long time. You've worked across a lot of different projects, but for some of the residential buyers, it might be the first time they're hearing about Dusk.
So we originally started in commercial property, so did projects in childcare, office space, fast food and service stations. We've transitioned to the residential market probably in the last 3 to 4 years, just seeing a bit of an opening in that market. It's been very difficult after COVID with commercial projects to get things to stack up. So the residential market, with such a lack of stock, a lot of migration and immigration to Southeast Queensland, seemed like a good market to target. So we've had a lot of luck in that at the moment and a lot of fun, and it looks like we're going to be focusing on the residential market for the foreseeable.
Yeah, I think with the way the kind of market's operating here in Queensland, having those kind of deep connections into sub-trades, builders and the like is like super important in order to make sure the projects can get off the ground and most importantly be delivered exactly how they've been planned.
So we've got quite a background in construction. We're very hands-on. We're actually project managers and development managers for other developers as well.
Yeah.
So for example, one of the larger ones we're doing at the moment, we're the project manager and superintendent for the demolition of Toombul Shopping Centre for Mervac.
Wow.
So we're pretty hands-on. We like to be on site every single week, make sure that the builders are doing what they need to be doing and making sure that everything stays on program and on budget.
And so what are some of the differences when you kind of are putting together a residential project, and what have you kind of taken from the experience? You're obviously doing so many in the commercial space.
Any kind of development that we do in the commercial space tends to be tenant-led. So we've got, say, a Puma service station or what's now Caltex. They've got a very specific box and format of what they want to build. They give us the specifications, we get in, make sure it works, and away we go. The residential market, we get to put a little bit more of our own flair, a little bit more creativity into the designs, and tends to be a little bit more fun. It's not as cookie cutter as the commercial market.
And so who are some of the architects and other kind of consultants that you've worked with?
The main architect that we've been doing some bits and pieces with recently has been Elevate Design Studio. They did the custom homes that we did over at Camp Hill. They did the custom homes that we did in Chapel Hill, and they've actually done the St. Lucia design as well.
So, amazing.
Yeah.
And so tell us a bit more about kind of who are the buyers for the project, and you know, you mentioned about having a lot of inquiry. We've obviously seen it's been quite popular in urban too.
So it seems to be because they're all three storey, they're all double lock up garage, they're all three bedroom with 2.5 bathroom, 5 out of the 8 have a multi-purpose room / office downstairs as well. We're seeing some downsizes, we're seeing some people who want to aspire to the St. Lucia market. There hasn't been too many investors just due to the fact that we've got a slightly higher level of product than what would tend to be an investment stock. So downsizers and people from more the western suburbs of Brisbane seem to be the target.
Yeah. Do you know, one of the things I think about with this market in particular is there's a lot of apartment product in SEQ. You've got quite obviously a lot of like established housing stock, but the townhouse product seems to be where a lot of the kind of opportunity is, where people kind of like the apartment stuff, but they want a bit more space, but they're kind of not quite ready for the established house yet.
That's right. Look, it also comes down to the zoning of the area. So when you've got a low to medium residential zoning with specific height restrictions, sometimes apartments aren't necessarily going to be economical to construct. Townhouses, it's a little bit better. You've kind of got your own lock-up garage. It's your own unique area or your own unique little home, as opposed to sharing a basement car park or whatnot. It just creates a little bit more privacy and a little bit more space to be used.
Yeah, great. And I think you've also worked on some other residential, some people that we've actually had on our videos before, in fact, on the residential project management side with the Sherpa Group.
Oh, yeah. We're helping out with a couple of their projects at the moment. They're Flourish on 6th down at Palm Beach, and their Terranora project as well. So we love the Sherpa guys. They're a fun crew.
Yeah, totally. I think, you know, as I said before, having those connections in market, you know, there are labour shortages, and knowing that you've got the infrastructure in place, whether it's working with builders, subcontractors and working with other developers, I think that stuff really matters.
Yeah, we've done a bit of contracting with DeLuca as well, and a number of other developers where we've gone in as the development and project management. So whether it's from the planning phase or whether it's actually delivering the project, knowing that other developers have a bit of confidence in what we do and are able to contract us to do it is probably a good thing.
Yeah, I agree. And so tell me a bit more about the project. Obviously, you're under construction. When are you expecting it to be completed?
Yeah.
So at the moment, we've got a 12-month build timeframe. So we started the start of July. So demolition was complete, pouring the slab next week. We hope to have it probably settled, ready to go by end of July 2025. So not a big timeframe to wait on this one. So anyone who's looking to buy, they literally should be able to move in mid-2025.
And so when people go down and check out the site, what can they kind of have a look at to get a feel for like what's coming up?
At the moment, we've got all the hoarding, which shows what the project's actually going to look like. So that's all up there, ready to go. At the moment, with the slab being poured, there's probably not a great deal to see.
Yeah.
Over the next couple of months, when we start to get the framing up and start to get the actual structure up, it'll start to take shape and people will be able to visualise it a little bit better.
Totally. So we're in the, just for context, we're also in the first week of August now. So kind of like come October or so, there'll be a bit more to look at.
100%, yes.
Awesome. And so tell me, how many townhouses are there in the project?
So just a small project, this one. 8 boutique townhouses, all very high level of finish, using designer appliances. We're using Miele appliances. We're using all full brass finishes on taps and hardware, even the engineered hybrid timber flooring. Stone benchtops, no silica, stone benchtops, with everything that's been going on.
Well, mate, it's great to kind of be part of the project. And, you know, I think that kind of mix of stock with the townhouse product coming into the mix, and obviously working with Colliers, who are a super experienced team, not understanding how to connect the project with the audience. You know, we're really proud to be working with you on this one, mate.
No, it's fantastic. Thanks very much for having me.